as a team, we were all very passionate about robotics. But in a sense, we didn't really know what was the latest trend in the industry or how to go about solving a particular problem. And where Yantra really helps is, you know, funneling our attention to a specific problem statement, giving us that problem statement that really matters, that has practical applications. And giving us this entire stage one, which is like a MOOC process, and stage two, which is practical implementation. I think that whole process of just getting you across with the fundamentals and then allowing you to experiment and then get those things in order and applying your theoretical concepts to something that actually works. Right, so that process is not something that you would get out of your college education. In that way, Yantra is a really good investment of our time, because in the least amount of time, we got to know so much about the various aspects to robotics, from design to software to electronics to control systems. So I don't think there's anything else out there that gives you this sort of a plethora of exposure within that short amount of time. Every time I'm here, I'm always going back a lot more knowledgeable and able to apply my skills to real world problems.
As I participated in 2018, where I had to go for my final year internship in an industry here. So when they saw that Yantra in my resume, they were like, okay, it's good that you participated in Yantra, because there were some students who did internship previous year who had participated in Yantra. So they know what is the standards of Yantra and how much students learn from this competition. So they were actually asking me more questions on how the competition was and how what were your learnings during the competitions. So that was actually easy for me to crack the interview for the internship.
When I participated in placements, these projects helped me a lot. I don't know what to say for that. Because of that only I got a job at Amazon, to be frank. So these projects really helped me a lot. Just doing software things wouldn't give you much fruitful things, I'll say. They asked about how you managed that robotics competition as you are from CSE background. That was in third round and fourth round. That is actually management and HR round. How do you manage teamwork and how do you manage if you have some conflict in your team, and how do you manage as a lead?
Anyone who's looking for a master's in robotics or looking for a higher education opportunity, I think this whole experience of what you go through in terms of real world robotics problems and getting hands-on with robotics, and like for example the disparity between simulation and real world robots. This is an example of what we see in the robotics competitions. What we design in simulation and what we actually get in practice are two different things. So these are things that you can talk about when you're writing your statement of purpose, for example, for your universities. And for me personally, when I was applying for universities abroad, I was able to do this, and probably that was only one of the major reasons why I was why I got an admit at a good college for my master's as well. Because of this competition, I think we are all attuned to now look at the stuff around us and take inspiration from different things that have been solved in different ways and apply that skill to some problem that we have at hand today. So that sort of creative thinking, wherein you can apply, you can see something else which is done differently by nature, and you can take that element of that uniqueness from that natural solution and apply that to your engineering problem. So that's definitely a different way of how we are thinking right now, because we are now not just looking at equations and formulae, but just looking around us to look for solutions to the problems that we have. When we have a problem at hand, we are able to solve that without panicking too much and in the least amount of time. So that's something that we got out of the Yantra experience, and I would personally take that away. Yantra is basically expanding my boundaries. That's what I would say. Anything that I thought I couldn't do, after Yantra, I'm able to do it. So it's really pushing my boundaries, pushing myself to the limits, and seeing what my capabilities are. So I'm discovering something new about my potential every time I come to Yantra.